All right, so we just finished up Deep Jungle. Now we got one more stop, and then it looks like it'll circle back down to Traverse Town, which is perfect because that is where we have to go. We got that navigational gummy piece, and we don't know how to use it. So we're going to go see if Leon knows what's up. But in the meantime, may as well stop at this world while we're at it. Oh, there we go. And after this, I should be getting pretty close to... I don't know how much more... I know I have to re-record this next world. Once we get back to Traverse Town, I don't know how much I have to re-record after that. Oh, also... Oh, man. Bam! Okay, that was a lot of ships on me all at once. Okay. Woo! Barely shot that out in the nick of time. Alright. Is that it? I think that's it. Nope, it wasn't. Sometimes these get, like, I think earlier in the game they were, like, very, very short, and then they get longer as the game gets further on. The very last one is... Last time I played this, I actually think I failed. Failed that gummy ship mission. I think I had to restart that. Maybe twice I had to. But on the very last world. Oh man. On the very last world, it was so difficult to actually. Which, I mean, it probably wouldn't have been if I would adjust these gummies like I say I won't do. But, you know, if I can make it with the basic one, I'm gonna do it. I don't know, maybe I should make it a goal to build, like, one more gummy ship or something like that. I don't know. Just for the fun of it. Come on now. There we go. Yeah, but... We're done with the Deep Jungle now, which is good, because, probably not gonna want to go back there for a while. It is actually, like, my least favorite world, but even as my least favorite world, it's still not bad. It's just, I don't know. It's a little bit weird to me. This one, though. This one is another one of my favorites in both 1 and 2. Also, Hercules was, like, one of my favorite movies, too. One of my favorite Disney movies. Another bit of Dalmatians. Good deal. I don't know if that's the case because it was just one that I, like, didn't see very often because I didn't own it, but it was one of my favorites. Get that Trinity again. Good deal. Two blue Trinities. Mithril Shard. Good. What do we got in here? Mega Potion. Actually, let's go ahead and restock that. Yeah. Restock that Mega Potion real quick. The Mega Potion's good because it does hit all three party members, which is quite handy. Alright.
Good timing. Give me a hand, will ya? Move that pedestal over there for me. I gotta spruce this place up for the games.
Okay. Try to move this guy. Weighs a ton.
It's way too heavy.
What? Too heavy? Since when have you been such a little... Oh. Wrong guy. What are you doing here? This here is the world-famous Colosseum, heroes only. And I got my hands full preparing for the games, so run along, pipsqueaks. Look, it's like this. Heroes are coming from all over to fight ferocious monsters right here in the Colosseum.
You've got heroes standing right in front of you.
Yup, he's a real hero chosen by the Keyblade.
And we're heroes too.
Hero? That grunt?
What's so funny? I fought a bunch of monsters.
Hey, if you can't even move this, you can't call yourself the hero! Okay, so it takes more than brawn. Well, let's see what you can do.
All right. This trial is tough. You got what it takes? You ready? Oh, I'm ready. Smashing barrels. That's it. Easy. Nothing to this. We got this. One more. Done. Not bad for a beginner, that is. Alright. Bust all the barrels within the timeline. Ready? Go. Actually, I think I'm doing this maybe a little bit wrong. That's alright. Be okay. I have a pattern that I usually do this in, and I completely broke it. Alright, good. Oh man, I actually might miss this one. I'm getting real low on time. There it is.
You know, you ain't bad, kid.
Looks like I'm headed for the games.
Afraid not.
Why not?
Two words. You guys ain't heroes.
Come on.
Want to become a real hero? Start by mastering this spell. All right, got thunder. Yeah, having the thunder spell's pretty good.
Rather a stubborn old goat, wouldn't you say?
Who are you?
Oh, hey, hold on there, Fuzzboy. Wait, let me guess. You want to enter the games, right?
Well then, hey, get a load of this.
A pass?
It's all yours. Good luck, kid. I'm pulling for you, little shorty.
Obtain the entry pass. Thanks, Hades. Now, interestingly enough, I think Hades, his voice actor is actually the original voice actor from the movie. I think it's James Woods still. At least I think so. I think I saw it in the credits at one point. I'm pretty sure this isn't Danny DeVito, though, unfortunately. But he's close enough. Hey, how'd you get this? Can we enter the games now? Well, I guess so. We start with the preliminaries. Ready for the preliminaries? Yeah, let's go. Some real weirdos signed up for the games. Better watch yourself. So, herein lies my conundrum with this, Phil's reasoning for not letting us into the games in the first place. And it's that there are heartless fighting. Why do they get the spot?
That's the power of the Keyblade.
Why did they get a spot and we didn't? You're no heroes yet, but you ain't doing bad. Lucky you came to me for coaching. something tells me he'll be a tough one to beat. Who knows, maybe you'll end up facing him. Yeah, Final Fantasy VII is one of my absolute favorites, so it kind of stoked me up that, I was really stoked the first time I played this and Cloud was in it. I like his getup too. Like a lot of people think like he looks kind of stupid, but I don't know. I think it looks cool. I like that. I like his kind of like costume change that he has in this one. It's also, I think in 2 they wear the same things that they wear in Advent Children. And I think at the point of this game, I don't think Advent Children have come out yet. You could be wrong about that. I don't remember exactly when Advent Children dropped, but. There we go. But yeah, I don't understand why it's like it makes a little bit of sense if like Cloud gets in and we don't. That makes a certain amount of sense. Or Hercules gets in and we don't. But the Heartless got in. Say, you're better than I thought, kid. Wish he was here to see this. Who? Hercules. He's a hero if there ever was one. Too bad he's off visiting his father. Match 4, Shadow Platoon. Yeah, just a little bit insulting is all. Max HP went up, good. There we go. I feel like in the original game you used to have a little bit more time in between, like right after the match ended, and I could kind of heal. I could be wrong about that. I don't know. Maybe I'm remembering wrong. Cause, like I said, I played this game when I was 10 for the first time. And I've played it a lot since then, but also I've played it on this, so it's
that little punk is your next opponent. Okay, I don't blow it. Just take him out.
The great god of the underworld is afraid of a kid? Sorry, but my contract says...
I know! You think I don't know? I wrote the contract! I know it says you're only required to kill Hercules in this tournament. But you gotta fight that kid to get to him! Come on! Hey, it's like that old goat says. Rule number 11. It's all just a game. So let loose and have fun with it! I mean, a casualty or two along the way. It's no big deal, right?
Jeez. Stiffer than a stiff's bag on.
Still, suckers like him are hard to come by.
Ah, big one. Alright, let's take out the small ones first. There we go. Okay, that should be all of them. Now this should be pretty easy. Got him. Alright, now I think... That was match 6. I think number 7 is Cloud. Now... This is another one of those matches where it doesn't matter if you win or lose, but I'm gonna try for it. The best way to kind of get him is to parry one of his attacks. And I think he'll... Ah, he got me. Oh, man.
That's the best you can do.
If you can keep away from him just long enough, he should be good. You gotta get... You gotta get close enough to him to where when he does the Sonic Blade, he'll like... Okay. Got like two more hits on him. There we go. Got him. Close. That was Cerberus. He's guardian of the underworld. Herc should be able to handle him. But then again, maybe not. This doesn't look good. Still got on items. So let's go ahead and we're gonna jump in there. This ain't just some match. This is for real. I'm not afraid. You can decide if I'm hero material or not. Careful, kid.
Kid, I got two words of advice for you. Attack!
All right. So, first thing that you want to do is lock onto one of the outer heads, not the middle one. Wait for him to stop shooting those fireballs, and then when they start to kind of get into that position, start attacking with bite attacks. And just wait until... So sometimes I'll throw you for a loop. Then in between attacks, just kind of knock the combo out. Dodge roll away. Just so kind of... You'll eat a few punches, but then when he does this, jump. So otherwise he'll get that shockwave. Do some damage to you.
Heal.
All right. Yeah, keep on top of that healing. Oh, this one. So when they start shooting darkness into the earth, gotta kind of dodge roll out of the way of these things, and then they'll start following again with the fireballs. But you can knock him back, which is good. Up, see? Here it comes again. There we go. So good. Like I said, just keep up that consistency of dodging his combos, and you're good. And see, here he goes again. Alright. That'll be it. That's it. There it is. Inferno Band.
Thus, I do hereby dub thee Junior Heroes and confer upon thee full rights and privileges to participate in the games. Further...
Hey, what do you mean Junior Heroes?
You rookies still don't understand what it takes to be a true hero.
So, what does it take?
Well... that's just something you'll have to find out for yourselves. Just the way that I did.
No problem. We'll start by proving ourselves in the games.
There ain't gonna be any games for a while. Gotta clean up the mess from that last battle first.
Okay, we'll be back.
I still can't believe that Squirt actually beat Cerberus.
Just between us, I'd already worn Cerberus down by the time the little guy jumped in.
My lips are sealed.
Obtained hero license. Alright, so yeah, it looks like, so Phil... you know, he's not trying to be, you know, mean to the gang, but he acknowledges that, you know, just because they beat a couple of bad guys doesn't make him a hero. It's pretty, I mean, obviously it's in the exact same vein as, you know, the movie itself, which was, you know, no matter who Hercules beat, he still wasn't qualified as a hero. And it was like, he was beating all these bad guys, and he was famous and all that good stuff, and still nothing, still not classified as a hero. And looks like these guys, they're trying to get into that same area. So we got another Trinity here too, but white one can't do anything about it.
Hey, are you all right?
Yeah.
So why did you go along with him anyway?
I'm looking for someone. Hades promised to help. I tried to exploit the power of darkness, but it backfired. I fell into darkness, and I couldn't find the light.
You'll find it. I'm searching too.
For your light? Don't lose sight of it.
How about a rematch sometime? Fair and square, no dark powers involved.
I think I'll pass.
I learned Sonic Blade. It's a good deal. So, as I was kind of saying earlier in the game, I like having the AP stuff because... even right now, we're going to have to start making decisions about what abilities we want. I definitely want to counterattack. But, you know, we got something here that raises max AP, and then we've got the ability stud, but that's only going to give us 8, which still isn't going to give us enough to have all of the abilities. So, you know, it's like at some level, decisions have to be made, and it's you know, AP is extremely valuable. It's like trying to get that up as much as you can, especially early on, because the abilities are ridiculously helpful. Just like that just that slap shot ability that we have, you know, it picks up the pace of how fast we hit, and then we've got the dodge roll. Dodge roll is like pretty much 100% necessary in this game, I think. The scan, just so you can read where your opponents are at. A sliding dash to help you close in. It's... they do make a whole lot of difference. And if you have to start, like, early on about which ones you can and can't have, it makes it a little bit more difficult. So you strike back after parrying an enemy blow. Successful counterattacks restore MP. See, that's a pretty good ability. Anyway, that wraps up what we've got in the Colosseum. Now, what happens after this, because obviously we didn't steal a keyhole, we just kind of beat a boss and won a couple rounds in a preliminary match. But because of the destruction that Cerberus caused, the arena isn't going to be available to be used for a while. So, we're going to leave, and then as we progress our story, we'll be notified that more and more tournaments will become available. That's what these boards are. These boards list the tournaments and the match that each one sits in. And if you win all of them, then you get make it to the top of the list. I believe there's four. And we should be catching up to the first one here very soon. But as of right now, we got nothing. So let's go ahead and carry on. We're going to be heading back to Traverse Town, and this might be the end of my re-records, but I might still have, like, a little bit, so I'm going to go check my past recordings and see where I picked up at, and then, yep, we'll just see where it goes from there. But it's all good. Let's give it another shot.
He's strong. He's kind. He's always there for you. And he's handsome to boot. He's perfect. Perfect.
Perfectly infuriated! He drives me crazy!
Wait a minute. What are you worried about? All the pieces are in place. Relax. Whoa, 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 whoa. Here's what you do. Let Hercules train the kid. In the next games, I'll take care of them both. Stay out of this. This is my show.
As you wish. Fight to your heart's content.